On one of my latest videos featuring Alexander Day, we discussed how he was one of the biggest NHL draft busts in history. Well, in today's video, Patrick Steffen will hold your beer, Alex. Once again, guys, make sure to go check out the description for all my other simulation videos. Make sure to leave a like and subscribe if you guys want to stay tuned and be notified of the latest ones. So Patrick Steffen was drafted in the 1999 NHL draft with the first overall pick by the then expansion team Atlanta Thrashers. Now Steffen's junior numbers were by no means impressive. In the ELH, Steffen only scored a total of 2 goals and 7 assists in 32 career ELH games. In order to get more adjusted to the North American style of hockey, he joined the IHL, which at the time was a minor and alternate farm system for the AHL in 1997. He only played 25 games that season and got 15 points, but improved on his play the following season, getting 35 points in 33 games. Unfortunately, a concussion would prevent Steffen from finishing the season, as well as missing the World Juniors before the NHL draft. Despite the injuries, Steffen was still regarded around the hockey world by most scouts, and saw him as a potentially dominant playmaking center. The Thrashers put the injuries aside and drafted Steffen first overall regardless. Those injury problems would once again haunt Steffen, to which he was only able to complete one full NHL season in the 03-04 season. That season was also arguably his best, in which he put up 40 points in those 82 games with 14 goals and 26 assists. Many thought Steffen would be one of those late bloomer type of players and would continue to improve upon his numbers, as he also put up very good stats for Ilves in the Liga League during the lockout. However, he continued to digress in the lockout shortened season and piled on more injuries. Steffen was soon traded to the Dallas Stars with Yaroslav Modrý for Nico Kapanen and a 7th round pick in 2006. He played only 41 games for the Stars, mostly due to injuries, and was healthy scratched a bunch of times, and finished with 11 points. Steffen retired in October of 2007 due to a hip injury, as well as all the other multiple chronic injuries from his past. Now, while Steffen will go down as a bust in the NHL, that's not the only thing he was known for, and it's not a good thing. If you're a fan of hockey at all, you've probably seen Steffen's biggest highlight, in air quotes, as part of the Dallas Stars in a game versus the Edmonton Oilers. On January 4th, 2007, the Stars and Oilers were locked in a tight contest late in the third period, with the Stars having a 5-4 lead. The Oilers would pull their goalie for the extra attacker in attempts to tie the game. However, Marc-Andre Bergeron would turn the puck over to Steffen, allowing him an easy lane for a breakaway tap-in to seal the game. With no Oilers players in sight, and instead of just shooting the puck into the net, Steffen skates all the way to the crease and tries to backhand the puck into the net. The puck takes a strange hop on the ice, causing Steffen to miss the net and lose an edge into the corner. While falling down to the ice, Steffen attempts to pass the puck back to one of his teammates, but it was intercepted by an Oilers player, who then transitioned the puck the other way, which eventually leads to an Aleš Hemský mini breakaway, and he scores with 2.1 seconds left on the clock to tie the game at 5. The Stars would eventually win the game in a shootout, but Steffen will always be remembered for that huge blunder and missed opportunity to win a game. Now, while the 1999 draft wasn't the best in its history, Steffen clearly was not meant to be the number one overall pick. So, what if Steffen had lived up to the potential? Now, due to the feedback that you guys gave me in previous videos, I'm going to be increasing the player overalls to reflect if they weren't busts, as the video should entail. Now, for this specific video, I'm going to take 2 current NHL players and use them as building blocks, only because I couldn't find Steffen's individual player stats anywhere online. So I used a fellow Czech player in David Krejci and Jason Spezza, because he had the exact same height and weight, to take stats from these players and use them for building blocks of Steffen. Now, from research, Steffen's defense, physical categories, and faceoffs weren't great, but his playmaking skills and speed were very good, so I focused on those. In the end, he ended up being an 87 overall. Now, since we are using Steffen from his Atlanta Thrashers days, we'll be putting him onto the Winnipeg Jets roster. He'll be playing second line time along with Mathieu Perreault and Blake Wheeler, as well as second line power play time. The Jets had a very good season, finishing 2nd in the Central Division with a record of 46-30-6 for 98 points. Steffen finished a career year with 60 points with 32 goals, second on the team behind Patrick Laine, and 28 assists. So it seems with the Winnipeg Jets roster, Stefan bloomed into a goal scorer, funny enough. The Jets playoff run would end though in the first round due to the Chicago Blackhawks in 5 games, with Stefan only getting 2 assists in the series. Looking back on this draft, then maybe general manager Don Waddle should have taken one or both of the Sedin twins and left Stefan on the board, because clearly it didn't work out for this now extinct, air quote, franchise. So thank you guys for watching. If you did enjoy this, make sure to leave a like, comment, and subscribe down below. Once again, let me know if you think that was an appropriate overall for Patrick Stefan. If not, tell me why I'm wrong in the comment section down below, as well as tell me some other scenarios or players that you guys would like me to focus on for the next video. Thank you guys for watching. If you did enjoy, leave a like, comment, subscribe as always. I'll see you guys next time. Peace.